Hi everyone, Pastor Ed here. As I shared on Sunday, this month we are all being given the opportunity and privilege of giving a special Christmas offering. God has been so good to us individually and as a whole spiritual family, and that really came into focus in our special Thanksgiving services a couple of weeks ago. Throughout New Day's 18-year journey, God has worked through us, blessed us, and has seen us through every challenge and every difficulty. God allowed us to be the first church planting effort to get firmly established here in the city of Eastvale. He allowed us to provide the first 4th of July events for the community at large, the first concerts in the park, the first movies in the park. By His grace, God enabled New Day to be the first congregation to acquire land, and He gave us the privilege of providing Eastvale with its very first permanent worship site and facility. In our young life as a church, literally thousands have made decisions for Jesus. Thousands have been ministered to, taught well, and discipled. Hundreds have been baptized into Christ. Hundreds have dedicated their children to the Lord and have raised their kids in the Christian faith here at New Day. When the pandemic hit, God enabled us to make the pivot to broadcasting our services, something we had never done before and had no experience in doing. And in spite of the pandemic, we have still been able, by God's grace, to reach over 100 precious souls for Jesus at our in-person services, and who knows how many through our online services, just during the past 11 months as we've been in our regathering process. And although many former attenders jumped ship during the pandemic and stopped supporting the ministry financially, which by the way has happened to the vast majority of churches in the U.S. as a result of the pandemic, nevertheless, New Day has been able to meet all its financial obligations. By God's grace, we have been able to do this because of those who did not jump ship and who have continued to support the ministry with their tithes and offerings, and because our Christian lender reduced our payments by 1/3 for 6 months last year, and because we applied for and received the forgivable federal PPP loan, which was forgiven, and we have been able to stay current on all our financial obligations because God led the leadership here to put aside a significant amount of dollars at the end of last year to fill in any gaps we might experience this year. And those gaps have been filled. Praise God for getting us safely through the pandemic financially and in other ways as well, right? He has been so very good to us individually and as a whole spiritual family. And we are grateful. And it's out of our gratitude, especially in this season, as we celebrate and are reminded of the extent to which God and His Son have gone to save us. It's out of our gratitude that I'm asking and challenging every person who considers him or herself to be part of the New Day family to give a special Christmas offering during this most holy of all seasons. New Day is not in financial trouble, but our financial cushion is now officially gone, so we could be in trouble soon. And that's why I'm asking and challenging every New Day family member to rise up this month and give a special Christmas offering that is both generous and in addition to what you normally give. Here's what I mean. Every month, my wife and I tithe 10% of all we earn to the ministry here at New Day. This month, in addition to our normal giving, we are going to give another $500 as our special Christmas offering. Many of you can give that same amount. Others could give more. Some may not be able to give as much, but could give $400 or $300. You get the idea. If we each give what would be a generous amount for us to give, New Day will end this year well and launch into 2022 on a sound financial footing. Thank you in advance for giving your special gift out of your love and gratitude. to God. I love you. God bless you, and have a great day.